We're celebrating South African film and currently a brand new film that is drowning in praises from critics to citizen cinema goers alike on the big screen. It's called Johnny Is Nie Dood Nie and it looks bound for immortality as one of our greats. So we're honoured to have producer Herman Binger and actress Ilana Seliers join us in the studio this morning. Good morning to you both and thank you for being here.
Good morning. Good morning. Nice to be here.
Looking at this poster, it reminds me of something out of like Train Spotting. But let's quickly take a look at the story, Herman.
And, that was actually based on there.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Boom. Okay. So it plays out between 87 and 2002 and it follows these student friends who are now these grown-ups. But give us a bit more detail on the story and what it all involves.
That's right. You see, in the late 1980s, as far as our film goes, we look at the rock band tour called Voel Vry, which was really a demonstration and protest against the government at the time.
Yeah.
And it was the old South Africa in the late 80s. Then we jumped to the new South Africa in the 2002s. And all these protesting young students have now become older,
yes,
suburbanites living in security villages. And they are longing for and thinking back and nostalgic about the days when they were rough and ready and protesting and full of life.
Yes.
And they are also reminiscing about quite a few things that happened during their student days that they can now shed new light on. What's interesting about the film is that our director, who gives us his own vision, was not part of that history. Because he was too young.
Yes.
So
yes.
It's almost a 2016 take.
Yes, on that.
On an evening that happens in 2002, where people reminisce about something that happened in the late 1980s.
And it's quite ironic as well. I mean, not only the fact that the director was not there back then, but this is also his cinematic debut, I understand, as well as you,
yes,
Ilana, playing in this, because you come from a theatre background. So
That's right.
It came to getting yourself into this role, what did you bring from the stage that you crossed over into cinema in order to make it work for you?
Well, I think anyone who's seen the film will know that the director chose to use really long takes. And I think there's a certain stamina in performance that a theatre actor has that means that you have to sustain a performance for 50 minutes to 2 hours.
Yes.
And they no cuts and you don't get to do things over and over and fix little things. So I think that helped a lot.
Yeah.
We were all theatre actors and we had to sustained performances over really, really long periods of time.
Yeah.
Even some of the scenes that have been chopped up in the final edit,
yes,
were all shot 12 minutes, 15 minutes, 16 minute takes. Yeah.
I mean, if you just imagine having to learn your script and embody that character for that amount of time and keeping that concentration, that is an immense challenge.
Yes, and there was also quite a bit of improvisation at the center.
Excellent.
So, yeah, lots of balls in the air.
Yeah, and what, from a technical point of view, I mean, just like you were saying earlier on, Herman, that you're basing this on a little bit of the cinematographic style of Train Spotting. Tell me more about the technicalities of what you decided to use.
You know, interestingly enough, because it is the directorial debut of our director, who's an accomplished stage director. Mm. He used a lot of the stage techniques in making this film. First, he gathered an ensemble of stage actors whom he had worked with before on stage, and they had all worked with one another. Mm. So there was a nice intimacy about them because they knew one another very well. And then they rehearsed before we even started shooting. But on the day, they would rehearse all day for that one long take. And then, obviously, in the afternoon when we have nice light, mm-hmm, when the light is nice and soft and your picture is beautiful, we go once cut. And you have got to crack it like you have to on an opening night.
Absolutely.
But you also, were chewing your nails.
Also, I was chewing my nails because if you lose that one shot, the day is lost.
Exactly.
And, you know, but we shot it all on Steadicam. Because we couldn't accommodate 4 and sometimes 5 in the flashbacks actors in one shot if we didn't have the Steadicam. So the camera moved with the actors, and then accommodated their performances as he moved along.
Wow.
The focus puller was behind the cameraman. The boom swinger was behind
it was
you.
Just, it was all happening live, right there, just like it was a stage. So essentially, that's what you're seeing. And I'm so excited for our audiences to go out there and see it, whether it is for the cinematography or for the effort of the actors that were on that set. I hope that we all, as South Africans, do go out there and appreciate our South African artistry. Go and check out Johnny Isni Duetni, and who knows, it might just live on forever. Make sure that you catch it at your nearest New Metro cinema.
Find the best entertainment at New Metro Cinemas. It's your scene.